In this video, I will be testing ZWCAD. I will show you how to use this amazing CAD solution as a supporting role in the BIM system. I will be exporting a 2D and a 3D CAD file out of Revit as well as IFC files, and then we're going to be managing them and continue working on them in ZWCAD. Let's go! If you don't already know, ZWCAD is an amazing CAD solution as it offers DWG compatibility, familiar UI interface with AutoCAD, and complete commands. Now, this is why you should consider it as your only CAD solution. It offers a one-time fee with perpetual license, so no more regular subscription payments that you see with most other software providers. On top of that, it's extremely fast and stable, supports powerful APIs, and it offers unique smart tools for workflow efficiency. Click on the link in the cards above and also down in the description of this video to check it out. And full disclosure, this is a sponsored video. Now, without any further ado, let's jump firstly into Revit. And here we are in Revit. This is my project 2 from our beginner course, and I'm just going to be using this for demonstration purposes. So let's first export this 3D file to DWG. So I'm just going to go here to File, then go to Export and find CAD formats and pick DWG. Now, when it comes to all of these export settings, I'm just going to be leaving them as is, and then I'm going to hit Next. Let's save it on our desktop, just like this. So I'm just going to save it like this, 3D view, and hit OK. Now, once that is done, I'm going to do the same thing for our level 2 floor plan. So let's zoom in on this floor plan. Then I'm going to go again to File, go to Export and pick CAD formats and pick DWG. Again, for all of the export settings, I'm just going to leave it as is, click on Next and save it on our desktop as well. Now let's jump into ZWCAD, and there's that familiar user interface. So now I'm just going to go here to Open File, and then I'm going to search on my desktop, and let's open up our level 2 floor plan over here, hit open, and it's going to open it up like that. So now I can use this to continue working on this project. Now we're just going to continue working on this floor plan, for example. So let's go to annotate, and then I'm going to use the smart dimension tool, and then I can start dimensioning different points here. So I'm just going to place one dimension. Let's then continue it perhaps just like so, going along the facade and annotating all of the grid lines. We can also use the smart dimension to dimension entire walls, for example, if we want to. So that's 2D plans. Now let's turn to 3D. So I'm just going to go again to open, and then I'm going to search for my 3D view and open it up. And you're going to see that it opens up that 3D view, and we can now continue working on that view. We can edit this 3D view, we can annotate it, so on and so forth. Now, that is all nice and well, and I like working with CAD files, but I'm really excited about IFC, so now let's explore IFC. So now we're back in Revit. I have a different file opened up, so it's this kind of structural file of the same project, and then I'm going to go to File, Export, and now I'm just going to pick IFC. Now, in terms of the setup, I'm going to modify it. So currently it's set to IFC 2x3 coordination view. I'm just going to modify this to go with IFC 4x3 and hit Okay, so now we have that, because with ZWCAD, with this latest update, we get support for IFC 2x3 as well as 4x types. So we have set up this version, and then I can just go to Export. And as soon as that's done, we can go back to ZWCAD. Now, this is the CAD 3D view, or the CAD 3D file. However, I'm just now going to go here to the Insert tab, and then I'm going to go to the Import panel and go to IFC Import, and that's going to open up this search dialog. So I'm just going to navigate to my desktop, find that export which I have created, and then hit Open. and that's going to open up the import settings dialog. Now here for the target drawing, I don't want to import it in my current view. I want to create a new drawing for it. Then for display settings, I'm just going to leave it as is. But as you can see, you can pick out different types in terms of the view as well as the visual style. I'm just going to stick with shaded. For the import method, we have many different options. So we have default, we have geometry only, building elements only, structural elements only, or MEP elements only, so you can kind of pick out different disciplines when loading in your IFC. I'm just going to stick with default and click OK. And the process is now done. As you can see, it's very fast, very, very fast, and this is what we get. Now, when you open up the IFC as a new file, you get this IFC structure panel where you can see this is the building that we have. Now, if I select any of the individual elements here, like this column, it's going to open up this tree and it's going to display where that item is. You can see here we have, it's called IFC column, and then we have the IFC number. Now you can search by IFC number. So for example, if I want to find this one and I know its number, I can just type that in here, 18559, search, and it's going to just display that one. As you can see, oops, it's this one over here. So we can use this search bar to search for individual elements. Now I can also add to this IFC. I'm not only stuck with the geometry I have, I can also add to it. So we can actually continue working on the IFC. So for example, if I go back to home, and then let's create a simple rectangle, place it over here. So I'm just going to zoom in a little bit. There we go. We have that rectangle. Now I'm just going to switch my workspace to, let's go to 3D modeling. It's going to make it a bit easier. So now I can select this and extrude it, and the tools are going to be there. And now let's say we want to add this column to our IFC. Well, what we can do is we can just go here to the building itself, right click and go to add elements with geom, and then we can just select that column, hit enter. It's going to open up the add new element window. So this element type definitely isn't a beam. However, I can define it as a column. So I'm going to do that. We can add the name of the element or description and so on. And this is going to be the parent element ID, obviously the IFC building 32, hit OK. And then this is what we have. As you can see, it's part of the IFC now. And yeah, there we go. Also, we can now find it here, right click and go and add a property set. So what this will do is basically just add a new parameter, and then here we can see all of the options that we have for that property set. And when we click OK, it's going to display that below here with the parameters for this IFC element. Now, to continue working on this, let's add this tree model that they have over here. Looks kind of cute. So I'm just going to Control C to copy, and then I'm going to paste it in over here. So once we paste in some geometry, we can also add that to our IFC. So just right click, add elements to geom, and then select that tree, hit enter. And for the building element type, I'm just going to go with the building element proxy and click OK. And now it's going to add that element over here. Now for this tree, I'm just going to right click and go to add a custom property set. And here we can name that set. So I'm just going to name that planting and then click OK. So it's going to add that planting property set over here. Now what you're going to notice is when we did this here, the layer is locked. However, I can unlock it and then I can, for example, copy this. So I can copy it from here to here, just like that. So if I want to add more of these trees, now they are IFC trees that we have just copied around. Now in terms of the parameters here, I can right click on the planting property set, which we have added, and then we can add a property. So for example, for this property, I'm going to name it variable. And then for the property value, let's just type in tree. and click OK. So now it's going to include that. We can then add another one. So for example, let's add a property cost. And for the property value, let's go with 500 and click OK. So just like this, we can start feeding information and data into our IFC file. And now let's explore what does this IFC file actually look like now once we have edited it. So I'm just going to go here to the ZWCAD logo, and then let's go to export and pick other formats. And now I'm just going to save this on my desktop, and let's call this one, let's just rename it and add new here. And for the file type, we can just find IFC format over here and then hit save. Now, just to see what that looks like, I can go here to insert and then go to IFC import. And I'm just going to pick out the new one, which we have saved on our desktop, hit open. And we're just going to go with a new drawing. That's perfectly fine. And it's loading it in. And this is what it looks like. So now here, this is perfectly integrated into our IFC structure panel. We have all of the parameters we have created and defined. And yeah, that's what the final IFC output is going to look like. Now let's go quickly back to the file we have been working on. And here, let's export some data. So for that, let's go to the insert tab, go to data, data extraction. And here we're going to be creating a new data extraction. Then I'm going to be using the current drawing. That's okay. Let's go next. Now here for the objects to extract, what I'm going to do is I'm going to uncheck this. Okay, let's say I only want to export columns just to see what that looks like. So I'm just going to use the shift key to select the rest of them and uncheck them. So now I only have the IFC columns. Let's then go next. Now here I'm just going to uncheck the description, slope and roll, and the rest I'm going to be keeping. Then let's go to next. Here this looks okay, so it's going to give you kind of a table preview of what that's going to look like. And now we can just simply click on next, and here we need to define where we want to export that. So I'm just going to go to my desktop again, and let's call this one the export.csv because it's going to be creating a CSV file, and then we can simply hit finish. Now when we open up that CSV file, this is what we have. So we have all of the columns from our IFC, and we can continue working on this table, continue managing all of this data. And that's what BIM is all about: inserting data into files, managing the data, and exporting that data out of files. And this is why I think ZWCAD is a perfect CAD support role for the BIM process, because it's a very affordable software that you can use for these very important parts of the project, for managing your IFC files, for exporting data out of them, importing data into them, and so on and so forth. So if you want to check it out, as I said, the link to ZWCAD is up in the cards above and then also down in the description of this video. Thank you for watching, guys. Make sure to check out my website, balkanarchitect.com, for more Revit courses. There I have over 120 hours of content, and I'm adding more each week. Make sure to subscribe for more videos, and also I've added a video over there that might interest you as well.